The Bible tells us the cities were in the plain of Jordan, which is the area surrounding the Dead Sea. Flavius Josephus, the first century Jewish historian, tells us, there are still the remainders of that divine fire, and the traces of the five cities are still to be seen. Driving along the coastal highway of the Dead Sea in Israel, one can soon see peculiar formations that are of a lighter color than the surrounding terrain. These cities were consumed by intense flames, a supernatural heat that was directed by the hand of God. Today, there is ash that is of lighter color than the surrounding mountains and terrain. Inspecting the formations closely, one can see structures containing man-made elements, such as 90-degree angles. This stunning structure stands out as a singular formation with four sides, surrounded by a deep moat. We move in closer to inspect the unusual features evident on the side of the formation. These swirling designs were also seen in other ashen formations in the cities. This is evidence of extreme heat, up to 6,000 degrees Fahrenheit, where thermal ionization occurs, when the electrons repel and attract, forming these unusual, swirling designs. Strange anomalies can be seen here, such as these fragile layers of material which disintegrate when touched. The limestone buildings in the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah were totally transformed into ash by the consuming fire of the Lord. When God unleashes a consuming fire, it will turn stone into ashes. At the perimeter of this city, one can see this amazing Sphinx still standing today. The Sphinx stands alone as a singular structure with a defined shape. This particular Sphinx has an obvious demarcation between its base and the soil below it, another sign of a man-made structure placed on top of the soil. One can also find loose or powdery ash that is quite thick and has been deposited next to the formations. In the formations themselves, some material can be gently raked off the surface with the slightest touch. Looking down the city streets, one can notice man-made shapes which are not found in nature. We can see the remains of walls that extended outward at 90-degree angles from the main structure. Once again, further evidence of man-made construction. As we pan across the city, we can see in the distance an arched doorway that exhibits a symmetrical shape even to this day. The most impressive evidence was this cremated bone fragment that was left behind from some lost soul of Gomorrah. The bone marrow inside was cooked until it had turned white. This is a moving testimony of God's power to destroy those who reject the Holy Spirit. Ron Wyatt was the original discoverer of these cities in 1989, and he now describes the brimstone found here.
Okay, we're down at Sodom and Gomorrah still. Right in front of you, see some unusual looking spots. Now what we have found, and we'll move in a little closer here, is that inside each of these is sulfur. That is in most of them. But the ones that don't have sulfur have a very black center where they have, where it's been very hot. But there are millions of these here. So this shows that God indeed rained fire and brimstone upon these cities. And if you look in your dictionary, under brimstone, you'll find that it is sulfur.
Back over at Gomorrah proper, we can see white, ashen worship structures built atop an acropolis or high place. Both a Sphinx and ziggurat are seen here, side by side, much like what we see in Egypt at Giza, with the Sphinx and the pyramids built in close proximity to each other. It is approximately 30 feet long and is quite impressive, both in its shape and size. Resting near it is the ziggurat, symmetrical in shape and also comprised of a special white material. On the outside of the ziggurat, we spotted a piece of brimstone fused into the side of the formation. Using a knife, it was opened, revealing the pure brimstone inside. The most impressive evidence was this cremated bone fragment that was left behind from some lost soul of Gomorrah. The bone marrow inside was cooked until it had turned white.
So I'm here in the deserts of Masada. King Horeb built some kind of palace on top of this mountain back here. And it's completely different terrain over there, and I've done a terrible job researching this, but I think Abraham looked down and saw smoldering Gomorrah. And I'm just retracing the steps of Wyatt, and he said you could see Gomorrah from the cable car. I think Sodom is further down south on the Dead Sea, but if you look at the terrain over here, it's totally different. Couldn't be more contradictory to where I just came from. There's nobody over here. There's no tourists. All of the ground is like talcum powder. Everything you think is a rock. I mean, just for example, this looks like a rock. I probably wouldn't be able to pick it up if it was a rock. And then you throw it down and it just completely breaks apart into talcum powder. I read on Ron Wyatt website, I think they estimated 6,000 degrees. So what would a town 3,600 years old burnt in 6,000 degree temperatures look like? There's some interesting formations. I'm going to try and find the Sphinx that the Wyatts found. I'm probably not going to be that fortunate. I got like 3 hours to catch the last bus to get back to Jerusalem. But you know, keep playing around.
These two folks gave you life. You should respect them every day of your life and appreciate it, because you wouldn't even be if it wasn't for them. So don't ever forget to do that. God takes that very serious. Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate.
Heavens, turn it up like a woman.
You walk around switching, you're not going to make it here.
Make mockery while he run around like a woman, committing every time he step his feet in those stockings.
My Lord.
He's pulling up.
Abomination.
Abomination.
And now we're going to find Satan, and we're going to actually figure out who's on God's side and who's on Satan's side. Is that fair? So they go to the house. Men, women, and children from the whole city and surround the house. The whole city comes out. I want you to know what that means. That means it's not just men. The women are sitting there screaming and yelling. What's going on? You got the men in there. You ain't supposed to do that. They got to go through what all of us go through here.
Men, women, and children from the whole city and surround the house. The whole city comes out. I want you to know what that means. That means not just men. The women are sitting there screaming and yelling. What's going on? You got the men in there. You ain't supposed to do that. They gotta go through what all of us go through.
Lot's wife, she kind of got accustomed to the ways of Sodom and Gomorrah. She was longing for those days when the men would drag men out of homes and do stuff to them. She thought that was okay. Or it was either that, or maybe she missed her hairdresser. You know, girl, you got to get a good style today. God looked down and said, you ain't no better than them folks in Sodom and Gomorrah. What good is it me taking and letting you get away if you bringing Sodom and Gomorrah with you? I get rid of it, but it's inside you. Shoot! Turn to the ass. Turn to the pillar of salt.